Slovakia, Fernando Arellano.
Okay, so welcome everyone. Thank you for coming. It's a pleasure for us to be here another year. And this year we're going to present a few of the dishes that you can find in our menus these days. We're based in the presentation today is based in how we try to make a traditional dish or let's say something which is nice to eat, make it into something that is surprising for the look, surprising for the somehow the emotion that it causes when you bring it to the table. And we're going to work on the mimetics. So we do different preparation with different techniques to have something that looks reminds the look of something. To have you know that special emotion added to the plate when it comes to the table. The first dish we're going to present is an oyster. The oyster we serve it with a kind of a carpaccio of beetroot, and we call it oyster majorica. Majorica is a brand of pearls that we have in Mallorca. Are natural pearls, but I mean they don't come directly for the oyster. They are made like we make our own pearl, but in this case they are made with natural ingredients, with natural elements like shells and fish bones, etc. Just like we do with our pearl, also made with edible ingredients. So what we have. What we have here is a type of sugar which is called mannitol, which is basically a sugar that you can bring to a very high temperature. It keeps away from humidity for a long time, so you can put frozen things in it. You can put liquid things in it, and it still stays crunchy. Also, it's not very sweet, so you can play also with it in savory cooking. And what we do here is that we have this mannitol melted down. It's a powder that we melted down, and we add some silver coloring to it, and we add some black coloring to give it the look and feel of a pearl. Yeah. Okay. It takes quite a while to melt. In the meantime, we're making a pickle. This pickle we have made it with the spices, shallots, reduced apple vinegar, reduced apple juice, and what we do is that we open a couple of oysters, and we add the juice and the oysters to this pickle, and we cook it out together. Yeah, please mind the manifold here. Just put a little bit more heat to it so it melts. It's getting quite a while. Okay, so we're gonna need two oysters for that, and then we're gonna need another oyster for the presentation. We're gonna open two for now. Okay.
Pretty much
good. So for now, we just I have this mixture already done. We have shredded shallots. We have added the vinegar, cook it down. Yeah. And then we just add the oysters out of the shell into it, and we're gonna poach it. We're gonna poach the two oysters.
Okay. Now this is ready.
Okay, so just keep it aside there, and we're going hot, because otherwise it's gonna crystallize. Okay, so we put the two oysters, and we're gonna lightly poach the oysters, yeah? Wait, we keep on poaching those oysters, lightly. Okay. Mm-hmm. So with this mannitol, we have these molds, that we have made with a liquid silicone. This is a silicone especially for alimentary products, and we just with the shape of the pearls, we just make the molds in the silicone, and we're just going to fill them up with this sugar. Okay, you have to be very careful when it comes to work with this because it's really hot. It reaches very, very high temperatures. Okay, and it sets pretty quickly also. So, okay. Anyway, so we have the crust there. With the help of a knife, we put the excess. Okay, and then we let it cool down because, as I say, it's very, very hot. Even if it's set, it's still very hot. So we leave it cool down there. Anyway, we already have some mate here that we took them out earlier. Okay. Good. So now we just need a very, very light poaching on these oysters. Yeah. And we have all the ingredients there. So we get rid of the spices. Okay. We don't need this. It's only for flavoring during the cooking. So we get rid of this. And then the rest of the ingredients, we can just put them into the blender, yeah? Okay. I figured out how that works in a minute. Sorry guys, you know how to close this? I don't know this model. Yeah, here you go. Thank you very much. Okay, just in case. This oyster pickle now ready. Yeah. Oh, sorry. Thank you. And then we pass it through the tummy. So we have this soury, but still sweet, perfume with the spices and the oysters juice that goes inside the pearls, and we're going to freeze it. Yeah, and still when it's frozen. Okay, thank you. Where are we going to place them? This. Okay. Otherwise, maybe now we look there, no worry. Yes. Okay, so we fill them up. Ideally, if we had the time, we would fill them up. Okay, put them into a freezer, and then once they are frozen, we take a little bit of cocoa butter. Yeah, this is butter from chocolate. Do we have another one of this? Yeah, this.
Yeah.
Okay. So we take a little bit of cocoa butter, like this, to make a seal, yeah? Okay, hopefully by the time we finish the show, we will be able to have this ready, and some of you, if you want, you can try them. Yeah. In the meantime, I'm gonna get the guys to put them in the freezer for me. Boys, please, do you mind putting this in the freezer for me, please? Freezer? Yes, very carefully, in the freezer, yes? Okay, let's pretend that this was finished, yes? Yeah? And that the liquid was already there. Okay, so we're gonna proceed to plate up the dish. We will go to the room with the pearl inside the oyster. The oyster will be closed, and so would be the lid of the box. This, as I say, this is a very popular brand in Mallorca and also worldwide of pearls. So we would come along to the guest and present the box like this, and beside it we would present this plate. Plate of this, quickly. The idea is that the customer can eat the oyster in two bites. So we have the oyster cut in half, just like this. Okay, and then everything is going to be done twice, apart from the pearl. It's gonna only be eaten in the first bite. Okay. So we have the puree. This puree, as I said, you should have the recipes. I don't know whether they were given to you. I guess they were. Do you have the potatoes? You can try this. Mm-hmm. Oh. Okay. Thank you. Okay, so we have pliers? The top?
No.
So as I said, this puree is made with vinegar, beetroot, a little bit of bread. Okay, it's basically like similar to a gazpacho, but made with beetroot. Yeah? This is just raw sliced beetroot. Okay, pass me the other one, please. Yeah, so this is basically raw sliced beetroot that we put one on each side, and then here we have little crispy beetroot, caramelized beetroot, made into cones also, with a little bit of the same puree and caviar. Sorrel, cappuccino leaf. Okay. And we will have the plate ready to roll, yeah? So we would come along to the guests, put the plate in front of them, then show them the box, where the beautiful pearl color is. And unopen it just like this, put it aside. Sorry. The waiters do it much better than me, I must say. And then come along and place the pearl in the middle of the dish. Yeah? So when you eat the dish, I mean, we invite the customer to eat the dish, they say, in two bites, in two spoonfuls. The first spoonful, you would take half of it with the oyster, and with the other spoonful we would eat the other half of the oyster, because the flavor of the pearl, sorry, I was meaning the pearl, half of it with the pearl and the other half without the pearl, because the flavor of the pearl on the first bite is so intense that even when you have eaten the first bite, it still remains for the second bite, you know. So this is one of the first courses in our menu, and it's really even simple as it might look, you know, the impact of the pearl breaking in the mouth with that iodized flavor from the oysters, but with that light sweet and sour taste, is really something that the customers appreciate a lot. Anyway, that would be that first dish. We'll carry on into the second dish. We'll do it next time. Okay, good. Y le van a subir a eso, ¿no?